Welcome to the Love Them Knives YouTube channel, worldwide studio headquarters. Okay, I'm just pulling your leg. But what do we have? We have the, well, it says TB, which stands for Todd, Begg, Steelcraft Knives. It's the glimpse. It is a Todd Begg design knife. It is not their mid-tech knife being made in California. It is not the full custom knife being made in Texas by Todd Begg. It is a production knife made by We Knife Company in China. And it is wonderful. Let me tell you that right off the bat because I am totally digging these knives. I am big time loving these knives. Now, with an L-U-V, capital L-U-V. They're just great. Just this G10 and carbon fiber is seamless. It's like somebody painted the carbon fiber on or something, because it's almost like this can't be like this. It's too seamless. It's just too seamless. Liner lock knife, okay? And these are really bright stainless hardware pieces, aren't they? With the typical Begg ceramic ball pocket clip. But look at how that pocket clip just rolls into the scale like that. Oh my God. When I first saw the glimpse, it was years ago, and I'd go, I don't want one. It was a friction folder, and I didn't know what the hell I was looking at. It was a friction folder, and it was a small little friction folder knife. And it was on somebody's YouTube channel. It was like, oh, you know, I thought all the glimpses were like that because I wasn't paying attention, which is sometimes happens. And I decided, no, I want the Bodega, the Begotti, whatever. So in any case, yes, the glimpse 7.0. came along, and you know, the glimpse is as big as a Bodega, okay? It's almost a 9-inch knife. Basically, it's a 9-inch knife. It's 3¾-inch blade. We'll tell you about it. I'll show you to it. So right here, 3¾-inch blade, maybe a skosh more, depending on where you're measuring. I mean, if you're just laying a ruler at the base, to that back of that choil is 4 inches, my friend. And are we at 9? Yes, we are. We're at 9 inches. We're at really close to, well, 22 and a half and then some. Between 22 and a half and 23 centimeter long knife. 23 centimeters, you're getting there, right? Anything over 22 is pretty good. So this is like 97 millimeter blade right in there. Now, let's see if we got 4-millimeter blade stock. I'm thinking we would. Really close. 3.92. Am I getting it all? There you go. Well, I mean, you know, Wee knives, right? I mean, most of the knives I've ever looked at from Wee are a 4-millimeter blade stock. 0.154 of an inch right there. This will not measure this handle. This is a handful. This is totally a handful. Let me make sure I'm zeroed out. Okay. This is a handful. 17 millimeters, whoa boy, 0.67 of an inch. So it's almost 7/10 of an inch. Not quite three quarters of an inch thick. That's some thick stuff. That's some thick stuff. I hope my lighting's okay. I mean, you know, if I do my lighting a different way, it kind of doesn't show, it'll change a little bit because it won't show the intensity of the carbon fiber. But maybe it's better this way. I don't know. In any case, so this is the tan with the black carbon fiber. Okay, so you're going to get three colors. Tan, green, and black. Let me show you something. Black. Oh, yeah. Hey, I couldn't keep this out. No way. No how. There's the black. Well, maybe my light would be better if it was down here. See the intensity of that? That is cool. I mean, that is the stuff right there. And you know what? Nothing like, have you ever seen like a black shiny black, like sedan or like Cadillac or Lexus or something, and it's got real shiny chrome, you know, accents on it. I mean, it does look sophisticated and really nice. And I didn't want a black one. I didn't. I'm going, this is ridiculous. Black on black. Black on black. Is it, you got enough black? You know what? I got it in my hands. And I go, oh, damn. Yes, I do. Yes, I do want a black one. Black on black. Look at that carbon fiber in that G10. How is that? There's one thing that kind of freaks me out about this. And these, okay, black, tan, and then green. I don't have the green. I'm hoping if the green looks that green, look at that green. It looks like a forest green. But I got to get one. So I will get one. I'll throw it up quick on the channel for you. Oh, by the way, this is Blade HQ. Todd Begg, Steelcraft, Series, Glimpse, 7.0, right? G10, carbon fiber. 3.5 blade. What's that, cutting edge? Because it, you know, what? Okay, it's close to 4. In any case, 9 inches overall, 3.75, so 3.375. I don't know what the 3.5 is supposed to be. In any case, blade thickness, yes. Material, CPM, S35VN, drop point, hollow grind, polished. It doesn't say satin. It says polished, and it is. It is polished. Not quite mirror, but it's awful shiny. Plain, of course, it's not serrated. 5-inch handle, 0.65, yeah, it's all of that. And 5.46 ounces, I'm getting like 5.2, 5.3 when I measured. Right hand tip up, and there you go, Steelcraft. It's the affordable production version. And you know what? Here's the second page before I go too crazy. Okay. Ceramic ball bearings, you know. I mean, it's just titanium liner lock. You know, they made a G10 version. It wasn't G10 carbon fiber. It was all G10. But then the liners were not titanium. They were steel. Okay. This is ceramic bearings. You know, IKBS. I don't know if they really show much here. I mean, they're just showing. Yeah, you can get it without the fuller or with the fuller. I definitely want the fuller. I think it's a design cue that I personally have to have. If you don't like the fuller, you can get the three colors, the green, the tan, and the black, without the fuller. Okay? I haven't seen the G10 versions. But I had one in my hands, and I have a review of that, and I will put that in the description section. I also had the prototype for these knives, the Glimpse 7.0, handmade Glimpse by Todd Begg, in my hands, and reviewed that, and I'll put the link to that also in the description section. And actually, it's owned by a friend of mine who bought that prototype. So slick. That thing was slick. In any case, this is your pass-through, and this is your lock bar that you disengage here. And they give you plenty to disengage here. I mean, it is right in your face. It's jimped. It's there. There is no denying it. See what I'm saying? Okay. It's almost too much for me. When you put your fingers here, you feel this here. I mean, you probably could have set that down like a 16th. You know, see how that is? It's above the scale. Now, they're making it easy for you to disengage the lock bar, but it's almost too much. And that's my niggle with this whole knife. That's it. That's it, folks. Because the rest of it is wonderful. Because I like the stylistic cues. Of course, this is the Glimpse. So if you don't like the Glimpse, then you don't like the Glimpse. If you like the Glimpse, you're going to like this Glimpse. These are $350. Yeah, that's some money. I mean, nobody's giving these away, right? But on the other hand, carbon fiber G10, you know, you buy just the mid-tech glimpse out of California, it's what, 1600 and up? So then this is starting to look like a bargain. I'll tell you what, just the action, just look at that. Look at the drop on this. I mean, that's really, I haven't touched it. I haven't put a wrench to it, nothing. I don't want to. This one's going out anyhow. So I got this one and this one. This one's going out. This one's going out. I'm glimpseless. Okay, but I'm going to get a black one and I'm going to get the green one. So I may come back on and give you an update with those and how I like the green and what it looks like in reality. Look at that. I mean, this is just, it's smooth. Okay, so there's no grip. If you were going to use this as a roofing knife or something like that, don't. Don't. Get something else. But yes, it does fill the hands. And yes, you have this wonderful choil you can go forward on. Oh, it's so nice. So nice. Look at how shiny that is. Look at that. Is that a great grind? Well, nothing. I mean, Riot was making the Steelcraft series for the Bodega, the Mini Bodega, the Big Bodega, the Field Marshal, and those are $460. This is $350. Now you go, well, those are titanium, and they're anodized, and they're all pimped out. You know, the good thing about these is that they're not a frame lock. They're a liner lock. So you got the present, the liners, I mean, the clip side open. There it is. That's a good look. That's seamless. And I'll guarantee it, these are not going to scar up like titanium would. I mean, titanium, I swear to God, the other day, I did something, just touched a metal thing to one of my titanium knives, and it's like, snail trail. I mean, it's like butter. These can slide around on some stuff and still look just fine. Just fine. So, you know, inside here, you can see the top liner, and the holes that are in it are just these holes that come through the scale. So, yeah. Other than that, they didn't skeletonize it. Did they need to? What's it weigh? Let's find out. Let's weigh both of them. Let's see what they weigh. 5.4. So that's what Blade HQ said. Now let's weigh this other one, and then we'll go to grams. 5.5. Okay. I swore I got 5.2 when I laid it down last time. 155 grams. Okay. There we go. 5.5 or 5.4, whichever strikes your fancy. See, that's the tan. That's what the tan looks like. If you hold it in this kind of light, that's what the tan looks like. Not bad. Not bad. That's a thinker, isn't it? The green will be a darker, so it's going to be interesting. But there's more contrast here with the tan. Don't know. I mean, it's, yeah, it's just going to be a personal preference thing. Look at how they did, you know, the pocket clip, the curve of the pocket clip, and how they've left this G10 underneath and haven't put the carbon fiber under it. So it all follows that curve, the curve with the holes, how it carries on into the fuller with the holes. And who knows? Maybe it can even be a knife. Let's see. Oh God, here we go. Yes. Well, that one works. Let's try the black one. I know you're beautiful. But can you cut? Yes, you can. I will not doubt you anymore. Just because you're so showy. Black on black. Look at that backspacer. I mean, that looks chrome. I mean, that is really glitzed up. I think Wii Knives outdid themselves on these. I really do. Come on, get these out of the way. Now you're making a mess. I think they outdid themselves on these. These are some of the best things I've ever seen from Wii Knives. Sorry, but you're getting a Todd Begg knife from Wii Knives. And the Wii Knives, I haven't seen a lot of bladesmith stuff, a lot of collaborative with known makers necessarily like you do with ZT or Kaiser or Spyderco even and some of the others. So this is really nice that you get the, and of course this is under the Steelcraft name, not under the Wii Knife name. So like the Ferrum Forge Falcon and Crux and even the Booze Smoke, what's that, TS1 knife. Although those are very basic knives, very basic. These, no. These are not real basic knives. These are a lot more work. Look at the machining. Look at how smooth these G10 scales are. I mean, that is really nice. They feel good in the hand. Of course, ergos are the same as the glimpse, any glimpse, Wow. Going forward, choking up, not a problem. 5.4, 9-inch knife, 5.4 ounces. Not bad for a 9-inch knife with basically 4-millimeter thick blade stock. Piercing, yeah, reinforced tip up here, yeah. Slicing, it can do it. It can do it. Big old flipper tab, isn't it? But you got this like cutaway down here. And look at this hog. I don't know. I don't know if... I'm trying to think. Should you have made the flipper tab smaller? I don't know. It's really comfortable, though. It's really comfortable. I think I'm pretty good with it. I'm not sure if you would have made it smaller. Could you have, milled out the center of this? Could you have put some jimping on here? Would that have been okay? Because there's no other jimping up here or on the blade. You see how they've crowned the spine of the blade here? You've got jimping, obviously, back here. You've got jimping up here, which it's so obvious and it's so above grade. Yes, it is going to give you traction for your finger. But maybe a little bit of painful traction, actually. That's a lot hanging up in the air. But you know what? I don't know. It'd be interesting to see if they brought this down a little. If they wallered this out and made that a little. But I don't know. I mean, the way it is, I'm thrilled with. Yeah, you got pretty good contact here. Look at that. God. You got pretty good contact. That's not bad. Yeah. Even with that flipper tab there, lot of flippers are like this. Boy, that's shiny, isn't it? That's really reflective. The action is just so good. And they are centered up. No lock rock, no blade play, no problems there. Now, so what do they say about these? Titanium liners? Is that what it is? I don't see any insert. Let me see. Let's get the old magnet back out here. Well, they're not magnetic. That's for sure. Not that, only titanium is non-magnetic, but this is not magnetic. There are steel that are non-magnetic too, but if they're saying this is titanium, then okay, I'll go with that. I'm not getting any lockstick. I don't know about travel or wear over time when it comes into contact with that lock face. I don't know if they've hardened the end of these lock bars, so I couldn't tell you. I'm not getting any lockstick. The action is beautiful. Just love these knives. LUV these knives. The action's so nice. So nice. Haven't taken one apart. Oh yeah, these are not mine. I mean, technically, yeah, they're passing through, but they're headed out. But I'm gonna grab me a black one and a green one, and I gotta compare. I probably only have the ability to keep one, but definitely this is one knife, and this will probably be the only Todd Begg knife that will make it into my forever collection. Because I just, unless I get rich someday, yes, the Star Strike Begatti, I'd love to have, but, or a, real nice bodega, but, you're talking 2 grand. It's just a lot of money. That's a lot more than I can afford to put in. And really, I like this better than I like the full-size bodega that's Steelcraft series, or the full-size glimpse. I mean, full-size Field Marshal, because those are 450, 460 a piece, and these are 350. I'll tell you, for even money, I'd prefer these. I just, for some reason, I really like this G10 carbon fiber deal that's going on here. I really do. I like it. It feels good in the hand. It really fills it out, and it doesn't make you scared to carry it, actually. Even though it's 350 smackers, it's man, it's just, that is so smooth. That is really smooth. You gotta feel that action. That is just smooth. It's glassy. There's no like metallic sound or anything when this goes down. It's quiet. It's just like it's pure oil on oil, just whoosh. That's really good. It's really good. They did a hell of a job on these. I've been waiting for these for a while. A while. I think there's been a lot of people waiting for these for a while. And I'm sure glad I got my mitts on a couple. And definitely one is going to go into my permanent collection. If not, if that green one is bodacious, then I got to have me a green and a black with the fuller and the carbon fiber. And I don't know. I don't know the status of the G10 ones with the steel liners. I had one, reviewed one. That was one of a first 100 production run that came from the Atlanta Blade Show in June of 2017. Don't know. Don't know whatever happened to those. I haven't seen those around. So I guess I need to stick my nose in the laptop and see if I can see if there's any around, because I didn't look specifically, but I didn't see any when I did my initial searches. Whew. Good looking tan. And so you got the three colors, and you can get them with or without the fullers. Okay, so just FYI, can you get these in stone wash? I don't think so. I think they're all this high polish, which to me is the way it ought to be, especially when it cost over three. You know what I mean? Whew. You better buff it up, baby. If I'm paying 3.5 for these, buff it up. But I really like this glimpse design. Back in the day, I was not hot for these at all. But I'll tell you what, they are a big knife. 9 inches. We like big knives, and we cannot lie. No, we can't. On this channel, is not blue. Oh, blue with black carbon fiber. Oh man, you got me thinking now. But absolutely gotta have one. Oh, well, I mean, the Steelcraft thing, if you've never had one of these, I guess I probably had to dump this out. I'm sorry. Okay, so fitted box, knife goes in there, great deal. Then you get this card. like this. Biggity bang. Congratulations. We just got 350 bucks from you. And you got the sticker. And you got this thing you can scan and register. There's your serial number. All the authentic scan codes and all that stuff. So whatever that means to you. Yeah. And this has got that, you know, it's got magnets in here. The closure. So if you just can't get closure, get one of these. It'll give you closure. And thank you for joining me on the Love Them Knives channel. Stay tuned. We have crazy and wonderful and weird knives all the time. These are not weird. These are just wonderful. Got a pass around group going on if you want to be a part of that. Advanced list on table sales so you can get your pick before it goes public on the table sales. You can do that. All right. Trader's Corner, 10th of every month. If you want to buy, sell, trade knives. You ain't got no money, but you got knives. You want to buy, sell, you want to sell, you want to trade, whatever. Do that. If you have a list you want me to read on the air, email that to me. Otherwise, you can go in the comment section during Trader's Corner and have at it with all the other guys. Hope that grows in the future. It's working for me. I probably got more trades than anybody else did out of that whole deal. But in any case, we are having a lot of activities on the Love Them Knives channel, so stay tuned. Thank you so much for joining me. Steelcraft Glimpse. Good. Great. Having a good time. Because you know what we do on this channel. We love them knives. So stay sharp.